The first Descendant is suffering from a bullet crisis, and this is prevalent especially for impact, special, and high-powered weapon types. As of right now, we don't have sufficient amounts of ammo reserve, and this makes the weapon types that I mentioned earlier not so efficient because there is not enough ammo reserve. Now, if you guys haven't noticed, every time you go to a void intercept battle, you will notice that everyone is almost using Enduring Legacy. The Enduring Legacy is the best machine gun in the game right now, and you can even say that it is the most used weapon for void intercept battles, not just because of its damage, but because it is very efficient. There is a trick to increase the ammo reserves. All you have to do is equip a weapon with the same bullet type. So for example, if you're using Enduring Legacy, you can use any general type weapon, and in my case, I am using the Last Dagger as my ammo reserve carrier. Equipping General Rounds Compulsive and Expand General Magazine will increase the max general rounds by 110%, so from 400 to 839 ammo reserve, which is a lot. However, it is still not enough, especially when it comes to Void Intercept battles or Colossus boss fights. You still need to find ammo, but it is a lot better compared to other weapon types. Now, you can do this weapon ammo reserve trick on any other weapon types, but it is still not as efficient as general ammo types because of the base or default ammo reserve. Some weapons only have 90 ammo reserves, like impact weapons, and some, like the high-powered weapons, only have 30 ammo reserves. So if you increase the max ammo reserve, for example Secret Garden, which has 270 base ammo reserves, and if you use another tactical rifle and equip it with special round storage and special rounds compulsive, it is still not enough, especially when it comes to void intercept battles, and especially when it comes to the latest Colossus, which has massive HP pool like the Death Stalker. Using the weapon ammo reserve trick gives us a total of 567 reserve ammo for the Secret Garden, and it is just not enough. And if you compare it to a general rounds weapon type which has 839 ammo reserve, then obviously I have to go for the general rounds ammo type. Not to mention that you have to loot the ammo first and find the correct ammo on the ground. And this is really a fun breaking task. Imagine fighting a Colossus and you run out of ammo, and now you are on a scavenging hunt for ammo. Now, I'm not asking for infinite ammo, but it would be great if we started the battle with full ammo reserve. This issue is even worse when it comes to high-powered round-type weapons like sniper rifles, launchers, and shotguns. Every time you loot high-powered rounds, it only gives you one bullet, which is insane, and this is why I always thought that there was a bullet crisis in this world. What's even worse is that the support drone doesn't provide any high-powered rounds. The developers are probably doing this because they thought that high-powered weapon damage output is pretty high, and this is some sort of balancing high-powered weapons. But the thing is that these weapons are not that great because of the lack of ammo reserve. If you are using a high-powered weapon like the Executor on any Descendant aside from Clay, and you use it on a 400% invasion mission, you can only use it for at least one bar of the commander's HP, and these commanders have at least 2 or 3 HP bars. As of right now, only Clay can efficiently wield high-powered round-type weapons because of her frenzied and increased sensory skill, which gives her infinite ammo. Not even Enzo can support high-powered rounds because he still runs out of ammo, and as I've said, I'm not asking for infinite ammo, but at least when we loot the ammo on the ground, give us the maximum amount of reserve ammo, especially in invasion infiltration missions, 400% invasion missions, and regular missions. High-powered weapons are not that special. It is on the same level as Enduring Legacy, let's be real. You can even see and compare the DPS number, and this is coming from a guy who doesn't trust the DPS calculation because there are modules that are not added to the total DPS number. Now, I am not asking for an Enduring Legacy nerf, please God no. There will be a massive outburst if the developers nerf Enduring Legacy, All I'm asking is that the developers need to buff or increase the ammo reserve of the other weapon types to make them more competitive, because as of right now, it is either Enduring Legacy or use Glaive paired with any other weapons. This is actually my second time experiencing this ammo issue. I used to play Warframe back in the day, and Warframe did have an ammo issue. As a matter of fact, I actually changed my playstyle because there is not enough ammo. 1 minute you are shooting at a lot of enemies and all of a sudden you run out of ammo and it is not fun. In Warframe, there is a gun called Fulmin. This is a shotgun and an assault rifle all in one. But the thing is that this weapon doesn't have an ammo reserve. Its magazine regenerates over time, making it a very independent weapon. Not only that, the Fulmin is not even my main weapon or primary weapon. My main weapon is a melee weapon because it doesn't require ammo. Imagine playing a fast-paced third-person looter shooter and my main weapon is a melee weapon, and this is what I use for survival mission which lasts for more than an hour. This is what I had to do in order to avoid the lack of ammo, but Digital Extreme did buff the ammo issue, but it was already too late for me. I already enjoyed playing this kind of playstyle, and in the process, this made me not enjoy and craft other guns in the game. I also understand that we should carry 3 different types of weapons. In my case, I always use Nadzestra's Devotion, which uses impact round, Enduring Legacy, which uses general rounds, and Piercing Light, which uses high powered rounds. What I usually do is start with the sniper rifle and then the hand cannon and then Enduring Legacy. But as I've said, all the other weapons just don't have what it takes for prolonged gunfights. The ammo reserve is way too low, and what usually ends up happening is I go back and rely on a single gun, which is the Enduring Legacy, or start looking for ammo on the ground. There are also instances where I'm using 3 different types of weapon and the ammo drop is not suitable for the weapons that I'm currently using. Why are we playing RNG roulette with ammo? It doesn't make any sense, and this happened to me many times. In Void Intercept Battle, we are supposed to shoot the ads because the ads drop ammo, but there are instances where it doesn't drop the ammo that you need, which is incredibly annoying. The fact that you are already using precious ammo on killing the ads and then you get the wrong ammo type is just insane. As of right now, there are really not a lot of choices when it comes to weapons for Void Intercept battles. Most players are using Enduring Legacy because it is a very good weapon with a very good ammo reserve. I'm really interested to the weapon usage data that the developers have, and I'm wondering what is the most used weapon in the game. To fix this ammo issue, it is actually pretty simple. All the developers have to do is let the support drone provide us with maximum ammo reserve on all the weapons that we are currently using, or increase the base ammo reserve for each weapon type. Also, the enemies that drops ammo should drop the ammo that you are currently using and not rely on RNG. For sure, this topic is wild because in my research, there are players that are not having this issue and there are players that have this issue. For me personally, the ammo reserve for the impact, special, and high powers are really low and it needs an increase. The developers did mention this topic in the first Descendant community Q&A, but they never mentioned impact and high powered rounds type weapons. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.